Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning to all our honored guests. Welcome to webinar session of the Higher Education Virtual Expo 2022. With me today is Puan Salwati Haji Muhammad Yusuf from Biro Kawalan Narkotik, who will be presenting a topic on Life Does Not Rewind. There will be a 10-minute session for this for question and answer at the end of this session. You can type all your questions at the chat area and we will try our best to answer them at the end of the session. Puan, are you ready?
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kita boleh mendengar, saya dapat mendengar di sini. Okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Maaf tadi tidak kedengaran. Perkenalkan, nama saya Salwati Haji Muhammad Yusof, pegawai narkotik, Division Pendidikan Pencegahan Dadah, Biro Kawalan Narkotik. Menyebut nama Biro Kawalan Narkotik ini, memang mindset orang selalunya menangkap lah tu. Yes, benar, ya ada menangkap, but may I add juga, Biro Kawalan Narkotik ini ada division lain juga seperti rawatan dan pemulihan yang di Pusat Alislah, division lain seperti pendidikan pencegahan dadah. Alright, kalau orang yang sudah kena tangkap ini, yang masuk pemulihan, masuk penjara, so you cannot rewind your life to undo it. Okay, yes, life really doesn't rewind, yeah. Okay. Ada yang bertanya, dadahan ni katanya dadahan ni big issue kah? Katanya, oh yes, definitely. Dadah is a really big issue all over the world. Yeah, major contributing factor to violence. And then ia menjejaskan juga ekonomi negara lainnya. Okay, yang banyaknya yang violence satulah. Violence to the family, to themselves and to negara lah semuanya. Okay. Apa sebenarnya dadahan ni? Kita ni tahu benda ni yang memang bahaya. Ramai orang tahu ia bahaya yang menghayalkan. Ia mengubah perangai seorang itu daripada biasa seperti indah biasa. Okay, ya dadahan ini sebenarnya bahan kimia. Ia boleh mengubah fungsi otak seseorang atau yang menyebabkan ia punya mood change, ia punya kesedarannya, and then tingkah lakunya jadi berubah. And that is psychotropic drugs. Ia mengubah secara physical and psychological. Kalau dadah farmasi, we call that itulah ubat yang untuk merawat ya. Okay, now let's have a look apa saja jenis-jenis dadah yang disalahgunakan di Brunei. Okay, Baik. Dua. Alright. Jenis dadah-dadah yang sering kali digunakan di Brunei. These are jabu, ganja, ecstasy, and inhalant, nyirok gum. But before that, there are actually, I wanted to share something. There are actually some deadliest drugs in the world. Tapi alhamdulillah sejauh ini dia pulang ada masuk ke Brunei, alhamdulillah. Just some are, if you ever heard crocodile, crocodile, it sounds like crocodile pulang bandar itu. It's ia boleh, this dada boleh rip off your skin and fall off your flesh. Macam, it's really macam alligator, you know. Ia boleh menguyakkan segala daging itu. And it can fall off, ia punya, ia ada kerasahan tu. Walau dia tangannya gugur with the bones itself, they're still hanging on it. Walaupun ia jatuh just like that. That is crocodile. And the other one is flaka. Flaka is deadliest jua, but they said the flaka and crocodile, crocodile is more deadliest. Flaka is, they call it zombie drug, which is, it can make you, kalau siapa menggunakan itu, it can make you like herky-jerky movement. Macam if you see the zombie, how they look like, well, that's how it's going to be. And it depends lagi how dose they're going to take. Di sini is famous in America. Diorang ada, maybe you can check from YouTube. It's very much, it's very scary. Yeah, it's really like a zombie-like. And there was one also, I found it, ada ia pernah chasing the police and then trying to beat the, digigitnya polis itu. Okay, but they managed to handle it. So that is flaka. Tapi harap-harap nak masuk Brunei lah. But I'm sorry to say, I'm sorry with my word, but it's going to be celaka kalau sekiranya is datang masuk Brunei. Alright, so we come back to Brunei. These are jenis dadah yang seringkali digunakan di negara Brunei Darussalam. Let's go to shabu. Okay, shabu. Okay, the history shabu ni, ya, mula-mulanya dicipta oleh ahli kimia, namanya, ini orang Jepun lah, ya, ahli kimia, namanya Akira Ogata. Ia mula-mula dapat membuat this one into crystal meth. And then after that, Jerman ada membuat, mempromosikan juga menjadikan ubat. And they called it jenamanya pevitin. This pevitin are used during the Second World War amongst the America, tentera-tentera America, British, German, and Jepun, you know. And then kalau di Jepun, diorang gunakan arah pilot kamikaze. So they use that drugs supaya they are very brave. Terus untuk suicidal lah. Okay. Supaya orang lebih berani. Now, shabu ni is often odorless, colorless, and tasteless. We'll see here. Ini nama-nama lainnya. You see ada ais, batu, kaca, this ada slang lah yang kekendai gunakan di Brunei. Perhaps ada lagi nama lain. Kalau ada, please share with us here. And this is the methamphetamine, if you see there. Ia bentuk-bentuknya macam itu saja. Ada berwarna and ada yang grayish. And some are clear. It depends, right? Okay, dadah ini buatan manusia sendiri yang membuat. Isi kandungannya, you see it yourself, more into macam poison if you put inside your body. Okay? Ada yang mengubah lagi isi kandungan itu, ada yang dorang mencampur bahan-bahan kimia lain yang membuatkan seorang itu lagi, ia akan lebih more violent. And then we are not what do you call this? We are not surprised kalau sekiranya di penjara tu ada yang, what do you call that? Because of rape apa? Because kadangnya it makes your sex higher, which is not in, which is not healthy and not safe to use this. Okay. There you are. Dia dijual bercampur-campur dengan these things. And like I said tadi, bahannya kadangnya kena campur lagi dengan bahan lain, which are more into poison. Kalau siapa membawa, mengedar lebih daripada 50 gram, hukumannya ialah mati. Okay. Hukuman mati means kan kena gantung lah tu, di leher. Now, we'll move to kesan syabuan ni. Dalam jangka masa yang pendek ah, tapi it could be lama juga. Hyperactive. What is hyperactive? Ya, diorang will act daripada luar biasa, daripada tenaganya tu luar biasa, indah macam biasa. Orangnya balik-balik. Semua sekali apa yang dikerjakan itu, balik-balik. He can go and fro, berjalan-jalan cuma tu. And then sampai they don't care, okay? Diorang dah ada terasa apa-apa tu, dia numb, right? And again, kuat bercakap, yes. Kuat bercakap, diorang ni kuat bercakap as though lebih kuat bercakap lagi, more talkative than talkative. Means that they can sometimes, diorang punya conversation, but the speech slurred. Dia dapat kata ni, it's not really clear kalau diorang bercakap. Tapi kuat bercakap lah. Okay, membuat satu sesuatu berulang-ulang. Membuat sesuatu berulang-ulang, kalau sekiranya you ask them untuk menyuci kereta. They can do that 3 to 4 hours balik-balik arah kereta itu saja. Okay. That is macam, ada lagi kalau sekiranya yang mekanik, yang macam tikus membaiki labu tu. Balik-balik itu. Tapi salah juga. Tapi dipajal juga. It keeps on and on and on sampai orang benar-benar kan habis barang itu. Okay. Again. Syakwa sangka tanpa sebab dan jadi ganas. This is it. Okay, kalau orang berumah tangga, memang ada yang sampai tangannya adi-beradi, apa, ada-ada saja kan dibuatnya tu. Syakwa sangka is macam orang yang dituduhnya tu indah membuat, tapi dituduhnya membuat ada tu. Sekiranya kena, ya, dia akan kena fikir ia mencuri. Sekiranya, I'm sorry about that. Let's say, ia kan kena, ia menuduh orang mencuri. Padahal barangnya indah kena curi oleh orang. Barangnya ada masih di sana. But that's, they used to it. Satu, dorang menjadi ganas. And then they tend to sampai tangan. They tend to, bukan sampai tangan menampar apa saja. It could be more than that. It could be more worse. It could be more violent. It could be macam menguyung sampai it could kill you too. Okay, that is kesan syabu. And also kemurungan, gelisah, and keletihan apa tu. And this, kalau orang ini, selalunya orang ini berwuri, kerana rumput lambai-lambai pun orang fikir biro yang anu tu sudah menyambangi bis dia. That is up to until that lah, orang punya urinya tu. Okay? Now, kesan kepada kesihatan, this is what happened. Orang punya heartbeat laju, and then the tantu-tantu, okay? And it also can cause cardiovascular, which is can cause to kematian. Alright. Now, kenapa ia merusakkan gigi? Sorry. Tadi ya. Okay. Kata ya, kenapa ia merosakkan sel-sel gigi? Because ia ada banyak dalam syabu, ada mempunyai banyak acid which can macam melting your bone, so as your teeth. Ia boleh bertukar-tukar. Ia boleh, see, these are the examples. Ia boleh merosakkan gigi orang yang pengguna satu sendiri. Now we talk about ganja. Nama-nama lain bagi ganja that we know, G, weed, pot, joint, Mary Jane, and then some are outside, they call it skunk, herb, gangster, what else? Tree, shatter, kif, you know, herb. Semua tu, they are all type of ganja. You know, spelling of Mary, M-A-R-I-J-U-A-N-A atau, but it is pronounced to be marijuana. It originated from Spanish language and then sudah spoken into Mexico in 1900 and become marijuana and soon after jadi marijuana lah. But still marijuana, but you pronounce it marijuana. Okay. See here. Oh, we'll see slides in the bergarak. Hang on, yeah, we're still fixing it. Okay. Okay, all right. We move now. Okay, faktanya masa ni dadah yang disalahgunakan seluruh dunia. Yes, it's all over the world yang gunakan this marijuana. And it's not surprising that banyak students actually yang using this, they thought that it's going to make you active, which is actually no, tipu tu. Yes, active perhaps, tapi untuk sementara saja, but then the permanent damage will stay longer in your body. All right? Please, for the people out there yang using marijuana, well, it's only, macam the, may I repeat it again, it's only sekejap saja yang punya hayat tu, dia punya the goodness itu is only sekejap saja. But then but the impact, the kesan of your life is going to be forever for that. Okay. Okay, kalau mengedar lebih daripada 500 gram, hukumannya ialah mati. Kesan-kesannya, selalunya this one, okay, there you go. Yeah, boleh mengacutkan otak ni, which is, kalau sudah otak kacut, and then your ingatan will be low. Maybe sekejap kali ganya ingat atau, but then pada masa yang panjang, you become unforgettable, cato, yeah, pelupa, atau, okay. And then mulut lagi kering, pasalnya ya tidak ada penghasilan air liur, and they call it cotton mouth. Pasal ia tidak dapat menghasilkan air liur. And then ia tahan berjaga malam. And then kuat makan. And then different from syabu. And some people yang ada, yang sharing, pengguna yang sharing ini, katanya it depends on your body juga. Certain will have this kind of kesan. But certain people, ia indahkan berjaga malam. Ia adakan tidur kanya. And then ia tidak guna makan. Sama macam efeknya macam syabu. Tapi depends on your immune system, your ketahanan badan. Right? Okay. Okay, there you are. Kalau sekiranya menggunakan smoke with this, this is what di dalam marijuana. There's a carcinogen dalam marijuana. Now we move to ecstasy. This is also one of the drugs yang digunakan di negara Brunei Darussalam. Nama popularnya, okay, ecstasy, love, pil kuda, gila. Oh my god. Okay, And then some countries they call it Molly. That is the popular, slang for molecule. Scooby Snacks, E, Adam, those are yang punya slang. And then ia dicetak di arah tempat pil itu dicetak dengan reka bentuk grafik logo with the commercial things. Yang kerana branded ya. This was popular masa di kalangan hippies in 1960s and then drag to 70s gay and then tahun 80-an more style kerana gunakan di kelab malam. Be very careful with the pills and jual because it looks macam lawa usulnya. It looks attractive that you might want to try, but please be very careful. This is a very kadang-kadang kena talan, and then kadang-kadang it is soluble in the water, which is odorless jual and is also tasteless. Okay, kalau once you consume this, it can make your body dehydrated, and then if you consume this, you cannot stop moving. Macam that's why dorang di club malam itu, when they using this, they tend to macam doing the head banging. And there was a story, masa tu makan ecstasy, and suddenly he had an accident. And then when the accident, he's supposed to die, but then dia punya kepalanya tu still angguk-angguk masih, you know. Maybe tengah nazak apa, something like that. So the thing is still going to your body, all right? Okay, there you are. Lama kelamaan, it can makes you akhirnya kematian je lah. There you are. Kalau mengedar lebih daripada 15 gram, hukumannya ialah mati. Now we move to inhalant. Inhalant ini kalau dulu ya famous di Brunei, I think 80s like that. They put it in a plastic. They put it dalam plastik, they put it in the t-shirt, and then they sniff it di dalam t-shirt itu so that they thought, orang dah kan tahu, but we still can smell of gum itu. This is kesannya, kalau kesan lama, ia boleh gila actually, and also you can die as well. Apa yang ada dalam bahan kimia, dalam inhalant, dalam gum itu? This is it. Okay, ia ada mengandungi bahan psychoactive yang dan bahan meruap. That's why it's very dangerous. Siapa yang doing this, ia akan menjalani hukuman seperti berikut. Now, we move to kesalahan dan hukuman yang ada di negara Brunei Darussalam bagi pengguna-pengguna dadah. Okay. Bagi orang yang memiliki bagi tujuan mengedar dadah, maksudnya ia memiliki barang itu, tapi belum lagi diedarkannya, masih lagi di dalam arahnya. So, itu sudah boleh menerima hukuman. Kalau dadah itu lebih berat daripada 100 gram, ia sudah boleh menerima hukuman mati. That is syabu. Kalau mengedar, kalau sudah diedarkannya, bagas tadi ia packing, now ia on the way, akan mengedarkan. That is also, kalau orang itu ditangkap, dalam masa ia mengedar, kalau dadah itu beratnya lebih 50 gram, hukumannya also mati. Import-export dadah. Import-export dadah membawa masuk ke Brunei. Atau keluar masuk dari Brunei. Kalau lebih daripada 50 gram, hukumannya mati. I'm talking about syabu ya. Okay. Now, memiliki bagi tujuan mengedar dadah terkawal. This is cannabis. Tadi syabu, when we talk about cannabis, sama juga macam tadi, but this is lebih daripada 600 gram dan hukumannya ialah mati. Mengedar dadah, tadi packing cannabis, now ia akan membawa cannabis itu kan di supply-nya saudara orang. So kalau lebih daripada 500 gram, also mati. Kalau memiliki apa saja jenis dadah terkawal, ini hukumannya ya. Kesalahan kedua, 2 tahun penjara dan maksimum RM20,000. Memiliki means it's in your possession. Walau tak sekiranya, but please be very careful. Sekiranya, ini dadah ini bukan main-main lah. Sometimes they fold it, small fold, and then put it in your bag kah, in your whatever size yang boleh yang dorang selitkan kah. Even if you don't do it, once kiranya you in your possession, you still salah and kira memiliki dadah terkawal. Alright, be very careful. And then memakan dadah terkawal. Memakan dadah terkawal, that's mestinya you just eat, no. This is terms of undang-undang. This is law term. Memakan dadah means menggunakan dadah. Okay. Memiliki alat perkakas bagi memakan dadah terkawal. Okay. Once you memiliki alat perkakas means that all the apparatus, all the instrument like bong apa tu, sekiranya, okay, let's say pengguna ni, ya dulu memang pengguna, but then lama sudah ia tidak menggunakan. Tapi barangnya ada masih dalam biliknya. If kena serbu, the thing is still there, masih dikira memiliki alat perkakas. Alright. Now for menanam cultivation. Menanam ganja, opium dan koka. Okay, menanam maksudnya walaupun if you have biji ganja, kalau memiliki biji ganja pun sudah menjadi salah. Dan apalagi kalau menanam ke dia. So, you can also bolehkan kena penjara, maksimum denda RM40,000 atau minimum denda RM5,000. Pernah sekali terjadi di Brunei, bukan sekali, ada beberapa kali. Diorang ni ada menanam ganja. Yang the first one itu, she doesn't know that barang itu ganja. And then, kan kena suruh, ya ni kan kena suruh, orang tua, ya kan kena suruh menjaga saja. But she doesn't know what it is. So, barang itu terpaksa dibawa ke pejabat birokal narkotik dan siasatan dibuat. And then it happens to be, orang yang menyuruh itu ialah anaknya lah, macam itu. But the mother ni, she doesn't know. But please be very careful, okay? Now, menghalang pelaksanaan tugas. Maksudnya di sini, kalau sekiranya ada tak orang birokal narkotik membuat serbuan ke atas sesuatu tempat itu. Kemudian ada bis kita menghalang orang BKN itu sedang membuat serbuan itu. Ani pun juga boleh dipenjara sampai RM5,000 ataupun yang minima denda RM1,000 atau penjara 6 bulan. Ataupun boleh juga kedua-dua sekali. Depends macam mana situasinya. Okay. Nawis memberi maklumat palsu, maksudnya sekiranya, okay, memberi maklumat palsu, sekiranya orang yang memberi maklumat palsu arah biro kawalan narkotik, sebenarnya barang itu ada terjadi. Orang itu boleh kami tuduh, boleh kami bawa ke mahkamah untuk didakwa. Dan orang itu boleh juga dipenjara sampai setahun ataupun denda atau kedua-duanya sekali. Atau memberi maklumat palsu tu. Now, kami juga ada akta section gagal memberikan contoh air kencing. So far, ada juga orang Brunei yang indah mau bekerjasama dalam memberikan contoh air kencingnya. Dan orang itu pun ada juga sampai juga ke mahkamah and then dan membayar denda. So far that I know, ya, dah membayar sampai RM2,000 lah. Atau gagal memberikan contoh air kencing. Okay. I think, so these are our atau contact number. Sekiranya ada apa-apa yang bis kita perlukan atau hubungi atau maklumkan, this is our contact number. Before that, maybe you can screenshot on this. And before that, may I juga. Okay. After that, please fill up this one for us. Saya bagi pihak Biro Kawalan Narkotik, and I personally begging to all of you yang ada menghadapi tekanan, macam dari segi kewangan, mungkin rumah tangga, any problem that yang benar-benar membebankan, but please don't choose drugs. It's not healing. You don't choose drugs because you don't have to take drugs. Ya, sekajap ganya tu, macam ia akan menambah lagi. It's going to be your issue going to be more bonus lagi with the drugs atau because you don't know. Ini perkongsian pepatah daripada orang yang pengguna pemulihan, katanya yang orang yang sudah terlibat dengan dadahnya, they said that one is too many, 1,000 is not enough. Can you bayangkan what that mean? Satu sudah anda cukup, apalagi it's endless. Walaupun dia akan bagi more and more and more, it's just going to kill you, you know. Macam, there's no end for the drug satu. It's just sekajap saja. They say for recreation, yeah, tapi sekajap saja tu. Tapi the kesannya tu is going to take you forever. Ya, dadah bukan jalan penyelesaian. Ya, lagi lebih teruk. So please hargai kehidupan yang ada masa ni sebanyak mungkin. Because life really does not rewind. For any question? You can check from our chat that is the link for our survey. If you have any question, please just you can chat. You can write down on our chat box, or you can bercakap saja.
Thank you very much, Juan. So we have one question in there. It's a request.
Cannot hear. Is anybody saying? Because I cannot hear anything. Okay, thank you. Okay, can we look how the zombie or crocodile look like? Because tadi dah nampak the slide. Oh, unfortunately, I don't have the slide for that. That was just tadi tu. I didn't put into the slides tadi tu. Yeah, thank you, Jim. Okay, if you can look arah tempat YouTube, ada sana zombie drug or flaka or crocodile, clockods, KLOKODIL. Yeah, that is how it pronounced, but they sometimes they call it alligator, sometimes they call it crocodile. Yeah, maybe you can check from the YouTube. Okay, what happens to the addicts after rehabilitation? Okay, what happens after rehabilitation di Pusat Al-Islah, they will definitely go into our they're going to cawangan pengawasan there for supervising. So diorang tu kena supervise, kena awasi maybe in sedalam diorang akan kena awasi seminggu sekali. And then dalam masa pengawasan itu, diorang urine sample will be taken and probably diorang akan kena interview. And then for those are going to take for 24 months, yeah, depends on diorang punya prestasi. There will be a stage for that, ada fasanya. But sekiranya relapse terlagi during the supervision atau diorang relapse terlagi, they cannot, we call that, they diorang dapat berhenti ba. Then we have to take action. Kalau sekiranya sebelum ini ia dialis lah, then we are going to nutup pulang ni, masukkan ia, mendakwa ke dia, bawa ke mahkamah, mendakwa ke dia. Alright? And then that will definitely penjara lah tu. InsyaAllah. Any more question? Will the addicts able to get a better future after rehab is done? Yes. Yes, insyaAllah. Why? Because, okay, here kami di Biro Kawalan Narkotik, we have this Rakan Harmoni. Rakan Harmoni ini terdiri daripada orang yang bekas-bekas pengguna. And then they are, we consider them success. But for them, they are not success because for them is, what is this? Pemulihan ini sampai end of their life. Alright? And berterusan. Diorang mesti menjaga. So kalau sekiranya, okay, so where was I tadi? Rakan Harmoni, yeah. So Rakan Harmoni, diorang ini diambil bekerja di Biro Kawalan Narkotik, and then they are now become a mentor. So some of them are working di Pusat Al-Islah. They are much more better, lagi lebih tahu lagi mengenai orang yang pengguna. And then another half of them, diorang ini berada di pengawasan. Whereas diorang yang monitor juga. Okay, so ada some, that is yang arah kami. But outside, yes they are. Ada yang sudah berjaya selepas daripada Al-Islah. They manage to, how to call that? They manage to jaga diorang punya rehab, pemulihan. And then some of them are becomes, apa ni? Some of them becomes director, manager, you know. So their success, as long as they are, as long as hati itu mesti kuat bah. Ya, bukan apa ni, dadah ni, kalau we government, we give them a lot of tools, actually. Macam dari Al-Islam bagi tools, we Biro Kawalan Narkotik bagi tools, how to overcome this and that. It's up to pengguna itu sendiri, macam mana dorang menggunakan tools satu. Kadang-kadang ada tools, tapi hati dorang dia kuat. Sudah hati dorang yang dia kuat, they tend to relapse, tiap. Yeah? Does it answer the question? Okay. So, okay, what are the main issues that led people, especially the youth, to get drugs in Brunei? What are the initiatives taken to prevent this? Other than warnings and reminding the public, what are the main issues that led people, especially the youth, to get drugs in Brunei? What's the main issue? Orang ini selalunya ada tekanan. Oh, I missed yang di atas tadi ya. Sorry. So, I answer yang ini dulu. Issue, tekanan. Tekanan dorang, especially tekanan peer pressure, tekanan family, belajar, and that all. And ada inisiatif. Ini ada inisiatif, we do the, this is it, peranan PDE, Preventive Drug Education. We are all here memberikan peranan macam bagi ceramah apa to the schools. And this is one of them as well. Yeah. And then and the roadshow and all that. Okay. And I go to Apabila bercakap tentang penagih pengedar dan pengguna dada, sudah pasti adanya perkataan pengangguran selepas menjalani hukuman dan pemulihan. Adakah terdapat sebarang sistem di Brunei di mana bekas pesalah diberikan pekerjaan sosial seperti pembersih, penyelenggaraan, bangunan dan jalan dan sebagainya serta pemantauan agar tidak terjun ke dunia dada lagi? Well, so far, kalau sistem macam ni, kalau di pengawasan, last time we try to find them a job yang dada bekerja tu. Tapi kadang-kadangnya heartbreaking bas, because there are some agency yang mau menerima diorang ini like cleaner and all that. Tapi sudah diorang bekerja, diorang bolah lagi. So sometimes, so agency itu pun macam, you know, they feel macam ragu tu juga kan. So that is it lah. Kalau macam kalau sistem itu, we don't have the system yang macam membuat supaya diorang cuma tu. But we try to find them a job juga. At the same time, they have to find their own job as well. Okay? Okay. Next question. Do I still have time, Puan? I cannot hear.
The question.
I think one more. I just answer one more question. Yeah? Okay. Out of topic, sikit. Since smoking can bring us to passive smoking to the surroundings, what about vape? Is it the same? Can you define more about vape? Vape. Kalau vape ini is a smoking things, right? Kalau sekiranya DAC dengan macam drugs like herbs, what I mean is marijuana apa, ada kan sampai cuma tu. Well, sama juga tu, ia punya functionnya, sama kesannya, what I mean. So it's also sama juga yang lebih teruk daripada smoking itself. But of course, we know that smoking is very dangerous. And so as vape, apapun juga dimasukkan di dalam sana, is still dangerous as well. Yeah? Is that answer all the question? I cannot hear. Okay.
Thank you very much, Puan.
Okay. Thank you very much. I'm sorry, I cannot hear you. I just ada chat box saja. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So for our next session will be on at 11 a.m. Okay. For who will be presenting on the financial planning by Taib. So I hope to see you again at 11 sharp. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.